bless me with the word because he has such unique way of ministering and sowing into your spirit. And so I'm older than him, but I look up to him as my father in the Lord.
All right.
Say real late. I was 35 and I got saved. So, you know, I got saved real late, but I fell in love with Jesus. That's what I never get. I went to church on a Friday night. And it was the devil trying to tell me, say, wait the Sunday I was sharing with the preacher. Man, I was so messed up. And when I decided to make a change, I had to find me a church Friday night. And the devil was telling me, wait a Sunday. Because, you know, the devil say Friday night is his night. Say Saturday night is his night. But when I went to church Friday night, you know what I found out? The devil ain't got no night. This is a day that the Lord has made. Y'all have a witness here. Lean on your neighbor and tell them, this is a day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice. I'm going to talk to you, and I won't be long, but I'm going to be strong.
Amen.
I want to talk about real faith.
My Lord.
Real faith. The Bible says faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. The Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But what is real faith? Real faith. See, a lot of people been talking, but what is it? And I found in the book of Genesis, the 22nd chapter, I found out what real faith is all about. Real faith is this, surrendering everything to God and holding back nothing. You got to surrender everything. That's why Jesus said in Matthew, if any man come after me, let him first deny himself. So it's surrendering everything and holding back nothing. But you got to grow to that place.
Amen.
It's a growing process. Paul said, when I was a child, I acted like a child, done things like a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. So as we grow in faith, we put away stuff. Because you know, when you first come, you hold it on to something. And most of us hold on to Isaac. But Abraham had to give his Isaac.
That's right.
And when you can give your real Isaac, you walk in pure faith. Until you can give up your Isaac. Listen what God told Abraham in Genesis 22. He said, take thy son, who thou lovest.
My Lord.
So real faith will cause you to give up that which you love.
Yes.
If you can't give up that which you love, then you're not walking in real faith. Wow. Say unto Abraham, take thy son who thy lovest,
yes,
and offer him up to me.
Yes.
Who thy lovest? He had another son called Ishmael, which came by the handmaid.
Uh-huh.
Hey God. He could have questioned God and said, God, let me go get Ishmael. God said, I know you love Ishmael too, but it's something about Isaac.
Yes, yes.
Isaac is your promise.
Yes, yes.
God said, that's the one I want to test you with. And if you show me that you can give him to me, upstairs.
Uh-huh.
And I'll make sure everything works for you downstairs. Because everything starts upstairs. What is upstairs? Your mind. He wasn't your kidding, but he had to kill him up here. And when he perceived that I take him up here, the angel told him when he put him on the altar, say, Abraham, do thy son no harm. God was testing you up here. Tell your neighbor what upstairs right. Downstairs would be right. But if upstairs ain't right, downstairs ain't right. And sometimes we try to get downstairs right. No. Upstairs got to be right there. So if a man thinketh, so is he. So you have to prove to God that you'll serve him up.